This video is going to give you the three most important biohacks for your mouth health. You don't need expensive toothpaste. Simple, small exercises. It all goes together. Just give it time. This is a video about biohacking for teeth. What does that mean? These are easy steps that you can take that are low cost, simple to use, effective, and this video is going to give you the three best ones, simply things you can do. If you want to get into more of the details, the science, how it works, what to do, I have lots of videos out there. So I know this isn't going to go into the detail. That's the point. I'm just going to remind you the three most important biohacks for your mouth health. Let's start with number one. Use what's in your mouth already, the spit in your mouth. Your saliva is amazing. It's full of the minerals your teeth need. Just give it time. Stop sipping. Stop snacking. The minute you sip water, you are diluting this amazing liquid. These minerals that come into your mouth at that point will rebuild your enamel. You don't need expensive toothpastes. It's in the spit in your mouth. If you just stop eating and drinking for a couple of hours after your meals. So number two, there are certain foods that are must-haves for healthy mouth. Now these foods may help your digestion. These would be salad greens, celery, beets. These are great because they circulate around your body and end up in your mouth. Then there are the foods that are directly good for your teeth. Cheese, wonderful. Something like a salty peanut is very good for alkalizing your mouth. Milk and dairy, and best of all, xylitol. Why do I love xylitol? Because it does so many things. It stimulates a flow of healing saliva. That's amazing in itself. It feeds the good bacteria. That's amazing in itself. And it gets rid of plaque, that sticky, nasty stuff. And all you need is a tiny amount. Mints, yes, they're easy. Gum, don't chew it for too long. And if you don't have either of those available, just a few crystals. Get the granular xylitol, big 1 pound bag, and just a few crystals on the top of your tongue at the end of a meal. Amazing. And then of course the third thing, of course we should consider our whole body health. And when we consider whole body health, in your mouth, the first thing is it has a rhythm. It has a 24-hour clock. The spit in your mouth that we've talked about gets better at noon and is the worst at nighttime. This is why you must go to bed with cleaned teeth, with protected teeth. Worst case scenario, if you don't have a toothbrush, you can't afford any toothpaste. And believe me, the one I recommend is $1.96. But if you're in a country where you don't have what you need, get some xylitol, a few little crystals of xylitol in your mouth before you sleep at night. That's so important for the circadian rhythm. And the second way you use your circadian rhythm, this 24-hour clock in your mouth, is to know that at midday and the hours after midday are ideal for mouth resting when you don't eat or drink. The other part of whole body health is that your health of your gut determines how many minerals get absorbed when you're eating and drinking, and then they get into your mouth. So it is through this process, you see your blood has a direct exchange with the cells in your salivary glands. So what you eat makes a difference in your mouth, and it takes about an hour for what you eat, those healthy things you eat, to end up fully mineralizing your mouth. So it all goes together, as you can see, the puzzle pieces fit. And then the final piece of this puzzle perhaps is exercise. And if you're elderly and can't do a lot of running around because that circulates everything, gets your salivary glands working, at least get your health of your mouth improved by perhaps placing, you know, yoga exercises are really good because your head is a little lower than your heart. Simple, small exercises. And if you're young, the more vigorous, the better.